In this video, I'm going to talk about two crucial things to focus on if you don't think you have enough faith for healing. This is one of the really, really important things because a lot of churches don't teach healing. You won't find this message everywhere. So I want to really break it down to you. What if you really don't think you have enough faith? You read the word, you read the Bible, you're going through it, you see that Jesus healed, you see that he healed them all within the Bible, but this is over 2,000 years later. Is it really going to work today? These are the questions that could be circulating in your mind, and you're thinking to yourself, and this happened to me too. I'm thinking to myself, do I really have enough faith for healing? And I was born again on March 5th, 2019, but before that, I was just on a real search. I tried all kinds of alternative therapies, healing, all kinds of things. But on the day that I was born again, March 5th, 2019, and if you are born again, the day that you were born again, you received the perfect faith in your spirit. And we are a three-part being. So we are spirit, soul, and body. So in your spirit, the day you became born again, you received the exact same measure of faith as Jesus Christ. So you have the faith in your spirit, but the soul part of you wonders, do I really have enough faith for this healing today? Is there really enough faith? You know, and sometimes, even though you have the perfect amount of faith, everyone gets the exact same measure of faith in their spirit, the soul part of you starts to wonder, and you still have to walk it out. You still have to have enough faith to take action steps to move forward with what God has promised to manifest your healing in your body. So one thing I always ask people is, do you think you have enough faith to be healed? And if you don't, the first key critical thing is to borrow faith. Surround yourself with a prayer team, with a very strong warrior prayer team that can speak life into you. That is the number one thing you need to do. And I'm going to share a story with you from the Bible of the man lowered through the roof, the paralyzed man. In the Bible, they call him the paralytic. The paralytic who was lowered through the roof by four friends that had very strong faith for his healing. So this comes from Luke 5, 17 to 30 in the New King James Version. Now it happened on a certain day as he was teaching, there were Pharisees and teachers of the law sitting by who had come out of every town of Galilee, Judea, and Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was present to heal them. Then, behold, men brought on a bed a man who was paralyzed, whom they sought to bring in and lay before him. And when they could not find how they might bring him in because of the crowd, they went up on the housetop and let him down with his bed through the tiling into the midst before Jesus. When he saw their faith, he said to them, "Man, your sins are forgiven you." So let me just stop there. A lot of the time, there's a forgiveness involved in your healing as well. So there's the forgiveness aspect, and then there's the healing aspect. And at the moment of salvation, when you are saved, you receive the entire package of salvation. So you get the forgiveness of your sins and you get the full healing package. And I'm going to be going over this more in my videos and explain it more and also share my story more. But for now, let's just finish the scripture. So verse 21, and the scribes and the Pharisees began to reason, saying, "Who is this who speaks blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" But when Jesus perceived their thoughts, he answers and said to them, "Why are you reasoning in your hearts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven you,' or to say, 'Rise up and walk'? but that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins. He said to the man who was paralyzed, I say to you, arise, take up your bed, and walk. Immediately he rose before them, took what he had been lying on, and departed to his own house, glorifying God. And they were all amazed, and they glorified God, and were filled with fear, saying, we have seen strange things today. So this is one of the very important scriptures on borrowing faith. So if you at the moment you became born again, you received the full complete faith that you needed, but still your mind, your flesh, people speaking into your life, the doctor report will make you doubt, is that really true? So you really need to have a strong team. This is the second key point, is to have a strong prayer warrior team of people around you who will continue to speak scriptures into you. Just like the man lowered from the roof, he had his four friends that were absolutely believing that Jesus will be able to heal and would be able to heal him. And when Jesus died on the cross, completed the finished work, and we received the Holy Spirit, we also, as born-again believers, have received the full authority of his name today. It's just like a policeman has a badge. And let's say a policeman is about to give a speeding ticket to someone. Let's just, as an example. Okay, so the police officer has the uniform. So as believers, we have accepted Christ. And the police officer has the badge, which is, as Christians, we have the authority of Jesus. So let's say a police officer is going to give a speeding ticket. So he pulls over the car and he's about to give the speeding ticket. And as he walks towards the car, the person rolls down the window and looks out. And then at that moment, instead of him giving the speeding ticket, which he has been given the authority to do, he has the uniform, he's been given authority by the police force, he has the badge. Instead, he calls up his police chief and he says, Chief, can you come down here and give the speeding ticket? This doesn't make sense, because the police officer already has the full authority to give the speeding ticket. It is just like that. Jesus has given us his authority, his name. We have the name, we have the identity in Christ, and we have the authority that we can speak healing to our bodies. And I'm going to be getting into that in the next video when I talk about speak to your mountain. However, for now, just to let you know, if you have any doubts at all, and those doubts, as you know, are not coming from God, they're coming from the enemy. So if you have any doubts that you think, I don't really know if I have enough faith to get healed, just remember, until you build your own faith and you continue to walk it out, you can borrow the faith of other people and you can surround yourself with a powerful prayer warrior team that will stand with you, stand on the word of God. So if you like this video, hit the like button, click subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.